Okay, we've got a motion on the floor by Commissioner Trample. And his second by Commissioner Tindall. All in favor of that motion, second, show by the raise of hand.
No, my bag of that was for what? To leave it like it is?
That's 30, 67, and 3, or 2% from each side contributing to a fund as yet undesignated.
Is that your motion, Jim?
Yeah, because, I mean, if we go back, we've got to go back through all this process again, do we not?
No, we don't.
No, you don't go back through all the process ever again, hopefully.
But I mean, if we don't vote.
If you want to match the city's vote.
Fine, if we don't match the city's vote,
then we're back to square one.
Then we're back to square one, are we not?
Not always.
Well,
but I mean, this is.
Basically, if the city did not accept the 28, 69, and 3, then we would be going.
It's all citizens of Jasper County money.
Right. Absolutely.
And we're all digging out the same pot. And our attempt, I think, was and continues to be trying to develop a relationship where the city and the county can work together. Now, I'm fine with however the board wants to do it. But
if we went back to 28, and I would put this out there, if we went to 28, forget kicking in 2% here and there. You get 28, we get 30 or 69, and we'll do with it what we want to. I mean, there's no haggling back and forth over what to do with it, where it goes, or whatever. You guys spend your money on what you want to, we'll spend our money on what you want to.
But we've got to get some tooth in the mind. The city's got to help contribute to the library. I mean, the biggest portion of that, and looking at the library budget, they're talking about roughly $120,000 in order to kick it back up to the 7-day operation. And they're even going to ask the Board of Education to help contribute.
Are we going to fund 100% of it, or are we going to fund 102% of it? I just don't think that's fair. We're doing this to people. I mean, I hate fair. I hate that word.
Well, this little law situation is impossible to figure out from a fairness standpoint, because every city taxpayer is a county taxpayer.
Exactly.
So every time a city that county taxpayer gets a break, the taxpayer that lives in the city also gets 2 bucks. You know, effectively. So it's very different.
Well, if we did it at 28,
yeah, we went through that whole thing.
Where do you at?
To sum it all up, if you vote with the motion on the floor, all we got to do is implement. If you vote with a variation that you discussed, Commissioner Lou, it's got to go back to the city, and the city would have to see if they will lower their expectations. So I'm not telling you either way, but that's just the process. And that process will then throw the ball back to the city, which opens it back up again for.
I guess I'm just looking at it from the judgment standpoint. If the judge was already favoring our offer to begin with, we're already stepping back 2% and saying, okay, we'll meet you in the middle a little bit more.
The judge always reserves the right to change his mind.
That's true.
Well, and then he also. Saying is that because they had lowered their expectations, then we were more closer together.
Yeah, and frankly, he was sort of hopeful that this might be a pattern that other city and county governments might try to follow in the future. If you can get a degree of cooperation.
And if we don't do it this way, and if it is our intent to keep that library open fully, then we're going to have to come up with the money from some other source anyway.
Yeah. Basically, be a county funded project just like it's been for the last 4 years.
Last 8 years.
How long has it been before that?
Since 2004.
You cut yourself 2% just to save face. So, where are you going to get that money and raise taxes?
Oh, you're going to do it.